Hey, 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 welcome to the DB channel, and today I do have an Alphos Hexblau blue deck profile for you guys, and I'll start off with the Digitama, which is the 4 Bermons. Very strong ability to actually draw one when there's no Digisource on the opponent side of the field. And next we do play 4 Vmons. Vmons is actually all the better rookies introduced with along with the team deck, and it does have a very strong ability whereby you can actually warp evolve to a Alphos and even have the draw ability, which blue sometimes really need, as this is a mainly a pieces relying deck. Next we do play Gomamon with the inherit ability to gain one memory when a Digisource is reduced or rather discarded, and we're actually playing four more, so same one from the Hexblau booster packs, which is pretty good because you do want the abilities to make sure that your evolutions become very cheap. And to round it off, we're actually playing one Pookie two cost, because 2 cost vanillas are actually always good. Next, the level 4, so we're actually playing 4 V-Dramons. Now this has the ability to bounce off a rookie on your side of the opponent field, and this is does come in clutch sometimes because usually against Hexblau, people will just flood the field and then they'll just kill off your Hexblau in their one turn, and then suddenly all the rookies can start crashing into your security and you wouldn't want that. So this V-Dramon is very nice, and sometimes, you know, the 4 cons hardcore ability is pretty sweet. Next, we do play the 1 cons blocker here, mainly for the 1 cons, and I would actually prefer you guys to try Grizzlymon if your matchups already or locals are playing a lot of Sharpmons, because Sharpmons does obliterate the 5k blockers. And next up, we do play 2 Lobomons, and Lobomon is always welcome in my opinion. Same as Alknimon, they are actually very strong because they are hidden, I would say lethal, in your hand and your opponent cannot really do anything about it. Now moving on to the level 5s, we are actually playing 4 of the Alphos level 5, and combined with the Digitama here, I mean the rookies here, is actually basically a 2 cost evolution, because when you evolve you discard your opponent Digisource and you can actually gain memory from there. Next we do play the V-Dramons, the Aero Force V-Dramon, which has a very nice jamming ability, so you can actually swing with your dual tamers, which I'll be introducing later, and does have the very strong Digisource that blue finally have, which is to gain a critical if your hand is 8 or more, instead of relying on the opponent field, something like this, because sometimes opponent can just not push any Digimon out, and your Digimon is just basically swinging for just one security, and that's just sad. Next, we do introduce the level 6 of the deck, 3 Hexblau. Hexblau is very sweet, and it does actually have a very strong presence in the week 1 of this set release, but however it actually goes downhill because it's just 11k Digimon and it can die to most matchups, especially the Lonimon with the Slash Angelmon, so this is not very nice. But this deck actually meaning to use the Hexblau as an offensive card, hitting over your opponent's blocker. Now something similar with the Alphos here, the new one introduced in the team deck, is that it can bounce a level 4. So bouncing a level 4 below means you can also bounce the opponent blocker, leaving them quite empty. Now to round it off, I personally believe that blue does require a level 7 follow-up, because their level 6 usually do not stay much long. So the perfect level 6 to play, the perfect level 7 to play is actually Omimons, especially the set 1 Omimon, because it does have a very strong nuke ability and you can bounce the level 6 back to hand, and especially this level 6 does have a very strong presence upon evolution, so you do want to abuse that. Now moving on to the tamer here, we're actually playing 1 Yamato and 2 dual tamers. The dual tamers are pretty self-explanatory because you are playing a Hexblau deck, but the 1 Yamato instead of a Devis there is basically because I do really appreciate me hard calling sometimes to remove the Digisource. As you guys can see, you do rely on yourself to actually having a body or rather evolution, and sometimes a Hexblau to actually discard any Digisource, so which is not very reliable sometimes, and you do want to actually use Yamato hardcore ability, which is not the best, but it does provide you that opportunity. Now moving on, we don't round it off with the memory option, another best card, the best card introduced in to the game in general, and lastly for Hammer Spark. Thank you for watching till the end, and do consider subscribing, dropping a like and a comment if you guys do enjoy the content.